Il dolce rumore della vita. This is the title of this exhibition. The sweet noise of life. It comes from a poetry of Sandro Penna, and it seems to me the right title for an exhibition of paintings and sculpture, the sculpture of Pat Gamble. The paintings are following two themes. There is a sort of cycle of paintings related to the image of Venus, and there are other paintings, a series of paintings related to the male figures that me, myself, I call as maschi d'amore, maschi di guerra, male of love, male of war. That second cycle is still open, still working on that, while the first one, the Venuses, is a concluded, is a finished cycle. One of the themes I explore is theater. Theater because I like theater, but also because it's one of the artistical field that I think most appropriated for us, for human being, to understand and know each other. The actor is the figure able to transform himself, to change, to give interpretation to many characters, but is also, just because he could be so many, is also very alone. So there is one of the paintings called The Solitude of the Actor. Iago is one of the main characters. Iago, how Iago could be interpreted? It comes, of course, everybody knows that Iago comes from the great classical theater, is a Shakespeare play. Iago is considered, or was considered, the betrayer, a man of evil, a nasty man. Is true or is as we are, just a narrator, just a man able to build a story, to build a thread, to make the event happen. My question is, in front of the beautiful paintings of the classical artist, the master, the old master, Velázquez, Titian, Botticelli in Florence, that depicted and represented the female figure as Venus. In front of these paintings, how we could today be related to the same kind of image? Is possible for our time in our contemporary world still speak about Venus? That was my question. I think that in the past the artists were representing a sort of idea of the female beauty, of the female energy, an idealization of that energy. Venus is that, is an idea, it was an idea in the past. It was the many Venuses in the painting of the past are represented as beautiful women without age, without time, without personality. They are icons. Today, how we can deal with this image? Is possible today to speak about Venus again? I try to represent in this painting a woman or women that are beautiful, yes, but is also they are also women with their personality, with their body, with a real body, a body with imperfection. L'amor sacro e l'amor profano, the sacred love and the profane love. This theme was represented by Tiziano in the beautiful painting that is in Galleria Borghese in Roma, and I was inspired by that painting, and I try to take the motif, the iconography that Tiziano built in this painting. There is a naked figure, the goddess Venus, and there is a dressed figure, the amor profano. The goddess is the amor sacro, the sacred love, and the mundane woman is the amor profano. So in Tiziano painting, the divinity of the goddess of Venus was sacred and was new, it was nude, it was naked, just because beauty is a sort of spiritual value. In my painting, I took the iconographic theme, but I changed the relationship. In this painting, the dressed woman is the mundane figure, the woman that is inside the society has a rule. She is wife, she is a woman with a rule and a position inside the society. Could be a mother, could be a queen. While the other image, that is the same model as in Tiziano painting, the other image represents the other aspect of femininity, sensuality, sexuality. These two dimensions are linked, as every woman knows, and I represented in the painting that link through the drapery. Here you see another interpretation of amore sacro and amore profano, the sacred love and the profane love. And in this interpretation you see the goddess that is sitting as again in a throne, and the two impersonifications of Eros. Eros is the representation of love. So is the representation of love based in the instinct, or is the representation of love that select, that choose, based on affinities. So you see love blind, just spontaneous, but also natural. And the other aspect is, if you like, more intellectual, but is also more direct. The second representation of love, it look at you, so it choose, it select. The warrior of seduction. Every woman knows that there is a fight to do in life. That image represents a woman that is using the element of seduction to win her battles. She is waiting to the moment where she will wear a beautiful dress, some jewels, and she will go out on life, in the street, in everyday life, to fight for herself.